Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Nandito na naman po ang inyong content creator. Magbabahagi na naman po tayo ng panibagong video dito sa ating channel. At kung hindi pa po kayo nakapag-subscribe, pindutin lamang po ang subscription button kasama ang notification bell para po update po kayo sa bawat upload natin ng video sa channel na ito. Kumusta na po kayo? Lalo na po ang mga taga-subaybay nating OFW. So sa ngayon na medyo mainit na talakayan itong ibabahagi natin mula po ito sa pandinig na ginanap sa Kongreso na pinangunahan po ito ni Congressman Dan Fernandez. Sundan po natin at panoorin ang kabuuan ng video na ito.
Meron lang kasi ako nabasa and it really worries me, you know, because during the Senate hearing yesterday ba or the other day? The other day, no, may nabasa ako din and I was able to read a news article sa Philippine Star. Sa Philippine Star, this was written by Ralph Edwin Villanueva noong February 28, 2020. And this pertains to the appointment of Superintendent Aji Bautista. Dito po, sinasabi that you were appointed as confidential assistant. Is that right? Were you appointed as confidential assistant by DG Bantag? Yes or no?
Mr. Chair, Your Honors, appointed na po ako noon na Administrative Officer 5.
No, noong September, nung in-appoint ka ni DG Bantag, ano appointment mo? Meron kang contract of service with Bucor noong November 1, 2019.
Yes sir, noong pong September 2019, confidential assistant po ako, JO position po yun.
Oh yan, remember you are under oath. Yes, ha? Huwag tayong magsisinungaling dito sa committing to, otherwise we will be citing you in contempt. Okay, so noong September you were appointed as contractual employee, is that right?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yes, and November 1 you were designated as the superintendent of the CIW in Mandaluyong City, is that right?
November po yata sir ako na appoint
yes.
Na
wait, I'm not asking about the appointment or as administrative officer yet.
Yep.
We will come to that, no. So what I'm asking you is after the appointments as a casual or a contractual employee as a confidential assistant, you were designated and appointed as superintendent of CIW.
Mr. Chair, hindi po.
Hindi ka na-designate as CIW superintendent?
Hindi po ako na-designate po nung contractual po ako as CIW.
Hindi. So meaning, nung November 1, wala kang designation bilang superintendent ng CIW. You are under oath. Remember this, ha? You are under oath. Pag nalaman namin nagsisinungaling ka, pakukulong ka namin dito.
Mr. Chair, ganito po kasi yun.
No, wait. You answer me yes or no. May designation ka ng CIW as superintendent?
Yes sir, meron po ako.
Okay. So meron kang designation. Anong date?
Hindi ko po matandaan sir.
November 1,
2019. Yes sir.
Andito ang human resource ng division ng Bucor. Andito ba? Bucor. Sino ang ating sa human resource? Remember, we have to remind all the resource speakers to please answer correctly. Otherwise, we will be compelled to do something that you will not like. Okay, sige. Human resource, sino? Please state your name and your position. Human resource. General Caltapang, sino human resource natin?
Nasa labas po.
We're calling them at the holding center.
Can you kindly call the, okay, while we are waiting for the human resource, Superintendent Angie, according dito sa news article, no, ako nagbabase ako sa veracity ng Philippine Star and the reporter si Ralph Edwin Villanueva, kasi at stake yung kanyang reputation dito. Sa pag sinabi mo na nagsisinungaling siya, ibig sabihin siya ang may mali at ikaw ang tama, and that's the reason I wanted to verify this news article na lumabas. At according dito sa article na to, November 1 ka na appoint bilang CIW superintendent. And that what I wanted to confirm. CIW ka ba ng superintendent ka ba ng CIW nung November 1 nung 2019? Yes or no?
Yung date po kasi sirang hindi po ako sure kasi po na-appoint muna po.
Kailan ka pumunta ng Mandaluyong? Kailan ka nagsimula ng iyong panunungkulan bilang superintendent ng CIW?
Nung pagkatapos ko po sir ma-appoint na Administrative Officer 5.
So, meaning nung ma-appoint ka noong November 11 sa Personnel Selection Board noong November 11, according to this, November 11, na-appoint ka. So meaning doon ka lang nagsimula.
Yes sir, yun po.
Okay, November 1 hindi ka nag-assume.
Hindi po ako nag-assume.
Hindi ka na-designate bilang superintendent.
Hindi po sir eh.
Sigurado ka?
Yes sir.
Okay, so nagsisinungaling tong si tong Philippine Star.
Kasi po doon lang po ako pwedeng i-designate sir eh kasi po bawal po.
Hindi, what I'm trying to say is kung na-designate ka through official document ng human resource. Tawagin yung human resource para malaman po natin. General Bantag, yes. Oh, panahon ni General Bantag. And the reason why we're asking this because merong gray area to eh. And we will be asking the DOJ. DOJ, you said the Deo Marco. Nabasa ko dito during the time of Justice Menardo, he was questioning yung omnibus rules on appointments and other human resource action in relation to civil service manual and the memorandum circular that they issued on 2017 precisely on the issue of a contractual employee no being designated in a position overseeing and supervising career official and being a casual appointment si Angie and supervising a regular employee that's constitute an unlawful designation. And that's the reason why we have to find out to ferret the truth out of this. Because in the first place, if she was designated as superintendent of CIW, that is unlawful. And all the emoluments and all the salaries must be brought back to the Treasury.
May interject,
yes, wait a minute. So I'll be asking DOJ. DOJ, anong findings nyo about this?
Mr. Chair, yes, sir, during the Senate hearing, it was raised by one of the senators. And to be honest, I was not aware of that situation, Your Honor. In fact, I had to send a text message to the secretary of the SOJ Guevara. And we were able to find that letter, Mr. Chair. It's dated November 4.
Okay, issued by the secretary. What's the letter all about? Can you kindly give us the copy and read it right now?
Okay, Your Honor, it's digital, but I'll have the original physical copy submitted to this committee today, Your Honor. The November 4 letter coming from the secretary, former Secretary Guevara says, if I may be allowed to read, Your Honor, the whole thing.
Go ahead, Yusek.
It's just three paragraphs. Dear Undersecretary Bantag, we write in connection with your request for the confirmation of Special Order Number 901, dated 29 October 2019, relative to the designation of retired Senior Inspector Angelina Lumba Bautista, former employee of the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology, as Officer in Charge of the Correctional Institute for Women, Bureau of Corrections, Mandaluyong, effective November 1, 2019. Pursuant to the revised 2017 Omnibus Rules on Appointments and Other Human Resource Actions, ORA, Civil Service Commission, CSC, Memorandum Circular No. 6, Series of 2005, and MC No. 26, Series of 1997, please be informed that the designation of personnel applies only to employees holding permanent appointments to career positions. Considering that retired Angelina Bautista does not hold any appointment or a career position, this department hereby negates the confirmation of Special Order No. 901, dated 29 October 2019. Please be guided accordingly. Signed, Menardo Guevara, Secretary.
Okay, so with that, Superintendent Aji, it's so clear, no, what the DOJ was saying and confirms that the this article that was written by Philstar constitute the rightfulness of their claim. Now you're claiming that you have assumed your designation after your appointment as Administrative Officer 5. Now you're claiming na nagsisingaling ang DOJ. Dahil November 4, yung kanilang claim na sinasabi nila na unlawful yung iyong assumption as superintendent of CIW and you were appointed as Administrative Officer 5 on November 11, 2019. So, Angie.
Mr. Chair, can I answer?
Go ahead.
Hindi po kasi ako na-appoint na correctional noong pong October. November pa po ako na-appoint at nag-assume po. Kasi nga po,
correct.
Kumuha po sila ng legal opinion from DOJ. Ngayon ko lang po kasi
Sandali. Nililito mo. Okay? Nililito mo kami. September sinabi mo, you were appointed as casual, as confidential assistant. And yes, after that, you were designated on November 1, 2019 as superintendent of CIW. Then nag-convene ang personal selection board and you were appointed November 11, 2019. And that's the reason why I asked DOJ. And November 4, they took action by writing a verbal comment and saying, citing Rule 4, Section 9 or Section 13B7 ng Civil Service and Memorandum Circular Series of 27 saying that contractual are not allowed to fill up plantilla position. Kasi that's the reason why I'm asking, asan yung human resource nyo? Kaya nga tayo nagkakaroon ng demoralization dyan eh. Dahil nga, ang nilagay nyo, from casual, pinilit nyong gawin siyang administrative officer in a span of, from, yun ang sinasabi dito, basahin ko. Ano sinasabi Rule 4, Section 9, paragraph 4 ng Memorandum Circular 24, Series 27. In no case shall a casual appointment to be issued to fill a vacant plantilla position or a casual employee perform the duties and responsibilities of the vacant plantilla position. Superintendent Angie, you were initially appointed as casual. And to fill up the position, nag-convene ng personal selection board para ma-accommodate ka doon sa position ng superintendent. And that's what I'm asking eh. So prior to that designation niya, ano mangyayari doon sa sweldo niya? Di ba? So ibigay niyo sa akin ang personal selection board, kailan na-convene? Meron kayong record niyan. Imposible naman. Pwede ba itawag niyo lang muna para malaman natin?
Wala ka bang ginawa eh.
Meron ba kayong ginawang personal selection board? Nag-convene ba talaga kayo? So you should know. Angie, you should know. That's a memorable moment of your life. Being reappointed as a regular employee. Di ba? Sige, Angie.
Mr. Chair, Your Honors, na selection board po ako, permanent po yung item na nakuha ko po.
Correct, tama yun. Wala no doubt about it. Pero, una kang inappoint bilang casual. At nung inappoint ka bilang casual at nilalagay ka bilang superintendent, ha? Acting, temporary, that is unlawful designation. Dinesignate ka for the meantime doon, unlawful yun. Yun ang sinasabi po natin. Yung designation mo, bakit wala na bang ibang magaling na superintendent doon? Sa 5,000 empleyado ng Bucor, wala na silang mapili? Yun ang iniiwasan namin ng mayor ako eh. Ang mga casual employee ko, magagaling, katulad mo, magagaling, pwede ko ilagay sa posisyon pero iniwasan namin dahil sinasabi ng civil service, bawal. Ako mo? Okay, since na hindi nyo mabigay yung plantin, yung personal selection board.
Mr. Chair, Your Honors, nag-apply po ako, may letter of intent po ako for the position po ng Administrative Officer 5. Magkaiba po kasi sir ang designation at saka appointment.
Tama ka doon. Nag-apply ka.
Yes, sir.
But noong sa October, sinabi mo, nagsimula ka bilang contractual. Correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
O yan, doon tayo nagka-problem. Dapat hindi ka na nag-apply ng contractual. Dapat nag-apply ka na antemano doon sa position na yon. But basically, what we're doing in our, being an organization myself coming sa LGU, ang ginagawa muna namin, ini-establish muna namin yung capacity ng aming mga structural organization. Inuuna muna namin kung sino ang qualified doon sa mga empleyado namin bago kami kumuha sa labas. Although, primarily and basically, lahat yan entitled to that position. Anybody is entitled to that position. But unfortunately, that will cause demoralization. That's the reason why kapag wala kayong makuha doon sa mga entitled na position sa inyong organisasyon, then get outside. Di ba? At hanggang may bakante sa plantilla, ha? Hindi ka pwedeng kumuha ng casual. Yun ang sinasabi ng civil service. Go ahead.
Mr. Chair, Your Honors, nung pong pumasok po ako sa Bucor as job order po kasi yun, hinintay pa pong i-publish po yung mga vacant position.
So, Angie, huwag mo nang guluhin. Kasi tama yun. Basta't kung na-appoint ka bilang casual, bilang job order, that constitute an unlawful designation kung na-designate ka bilang superintendent.